In this video, I will talk about voltage tripler circuit. What is a voltage tripler circuit? The voltage tripler circuit is a circuit which will give us the peak value of in the output voltage, which will be the 3 times of the peak value of the input voltage. Let's say I am applying a sinusoidal waveform in the input side with its maximum or peak value Vm. In the output side, I will get a output voltage, rectified output voltage or DC output voltage, whose maximum value will be 3 times of this peak value or maximum value. That's why this is known as voltage tripler circuit. And this is the circuit arrangement of a voltage tripler circuit. You will see that here I have used polar capacitor C1, C2 and C3. If this is a polar capacitor, this terminal will be its positive terminal and this terminal will be its negative terminal, and the polar capacitor will only get charged when the charging current flows in this direction. It cannot get charged when the charging current flow in this direction. Only it will get charged if the charging current flows in this direction, that means from left to right. That means this capacitor will get charged if the charging current enters from this direction and leaves the negative terminal of the capacitor in this direction. The capacitor C1 will get charged only if the charging current flows in this direction, and the capacitor C3 will get charged if the charging current flows in this direction. Okay, just remember it. Now let me describe the operation of this voltage tripler circuit. I am applying an alternating sinusoidal voltage between this terminal, and I am taking the output across the capacitor or the load resistor RL. So during the positive half cycle of the applied input voltage, this terminal will be positive and this terminal of the will be negative, and you will see that the positive terminal is connected with the P side of the diode and the negative terminal of the input voltage is connected with the N side of the diode. That means this diode D1 will be in forward bias during the positive half cycle. Okay, so when a diode is in forward bias, I can replace that diode with a short circuit. Okay, so I can replace the diode D1 with a short circuit. That means from this point to this point I will get it total short path, and during this positive half cycle the total current will flow from this terminal up to this negative terminal. The capacitor C2 cannot get charged because this will be its negative terminal and this will be its positive terminal. It will get charged only if the charging current flow from this direction. Okay, as the charging current should be flowing from this direction, therefore this capacitor C2 cannot get charged. Therefore, due to its insulation between the metal contacts, the current through this branch will be equal to zero. So when the current in any branch is equal to zero, that means the branch will act as an open circuit. So when a branch acts as an open circuit, I can remove that branch from our circuit. Now let's say the source is emitting a current I here, and you will see that this source current will follow this path because this is a short circuit. When it gets into this point, it will see that we have two diodes D2 and D3 and a capacitor C3 is connected from between this point to this point, and this capacitor C3 has infinite resistance because of its insulation between the two metal contacts. Therefore the total current I will not follow this path, rather it will flow in this direction and completes its journey by following this path up to this negative terminal. And you will see that as the charging current is entering this direction, our capacitor C1 now gets charged and it will store that charge as a voltage of VC1, let's say, as the current in this branch is equal to zero. Therefore the diode D2 and D3 will be in off state. So when a diode is in off state, I can replace them with an open circuit. That means I can remove this entire branch from our original or given circuit. So if I remove the branch with D2, D3 and C3, our circuit will look like this. and the now consider the max when the input voltage is at its maximum value. It will have a peak value of Vm. Now I want to calculate the voltage that is stored in this capacitor C1. To do that, I have to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in the clockwise direction in this closed loop. At first, I will encounter this voltage source and its negative terminal, therefore its voltage will be positive. After that, I will encounter this capacitor and its positive terminal, therefore its voltage should be negative. Plus Vm minus Vc1 will be equal to 0, therefore our Vc1 will be equal to Vm. That means during this positive half cycle, our capacitor will store a voltage equal to maximum value of the input voltage during this positive half cycle. Now consider the negative half cycle of the input voltage. It has a maximum value of minus Vm. This terminal will be negative and this terminal will be positive. This negative terminal will be connected with the inside of the diode D2 and the positive terminal of the input voltage will be connected with the P side of the diode D2, and the capacitor during the negative half cycle will store a voltage of Vm and it will find a way to discharge this voltage in any means. Now see, this positive terminal of the capacitor is connected with the P side of the diode D2 and the negative terminal is connected with the N side of the diode D2 through this voltage source. Both this capacitor voltage and the input voltage are trying to drive the diode D2 in forward bias. That means this diode D2 will be in forward bias, and when a diode is in forward bias, I can replace them with a short circuit. This positive terminal will be connected with the N side of the diode and this negative terminal will be connected with the P side of the diode. The negative terminal of the input voltage is connected with the P side of the diode and the positive terminal is connected with the inside of the diode. That means both this capacitor voltage and the input voltages are trying to drive the diode D1 in reverse bias. So I can replace this diode D1 with an open circuit and D2 with a short circuit. Now let me do that. During this negative half cycle, if I consider the source current should flow in this direction and it will flow like this. It should flow in the outer region of the capacitor like this, and as it is entering from the negative side of the capacitor and leaving this capacitor C3 from the positive side of the capacitor, therefore the capacitor C3 cannot get charged. Current in the outside region of the capacitor C3 will be equal to zero. As the load resistor of a voltage stabilizer circuit is very high, therefore I can assume that a very small amount of current should flow in this direction, but you will see that the positive terminal of the input voltage will be connected with the inside of the diode and the negative terminal of the input voltage is connected with the P side of the diode, but our diode D3 should be in reverse bias, and as the capacitor C3 cannot get charged during this negative half cycle, if I consider both the effect, the reverse bias of the diode D3 and the polarity C3, the current through the load resistor is equal to zero. The total current that is flowing from this, the total current that is flowing in this branch will be equal to zero. So when the current in any branch is equal to zero, I can compare them with an open circuit. So if I get an open circuit in a circuit, I can remove that branch from our original circuit. Now let me do that. I will replace this D3 C3 RL branch with an open circuit, or remove this branch from our given circuit. See here, I have removed the branch, okay, and during this negative half cycle our capacitor C1 will get a short path to discharge its voltage. It will discharge through this way, C1 C2 C1 C2, this negative term and the voltage source V I, and this from positive terminal to up to this negative terminal of the capacitor C1. That means during the negative cycle I have to consider the input voltage and the voltage that is stored in this capacitor C1. 1. Sorry, this is the positive terminal of the capacitor C2 and this is the negative terminal of the capacitor C2. This is the negative terminal and this is the positive terminal and it is storing the charge as a voltage VC2. So to calculate the VC2, I will apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in this loop in clockwise direction. So if I apply KVL in this loop, I will get at first this input voltage and its positive terminal, so its voltage will be negative. After that I will encounter this capacitor C2 and its negative terminal, therefore its voltage will be positive VC2. After that I will encounter this capacitor C1 and its positive terminal, therefore its voltage should be negative minus Vm, from which I can calculate that VC2 will be equal to 2Vm. That means during this negative half cycle, the voltage that is stored in this capacitor C2 will be equal to 2Vm, twice the maximum value of the input voltage. Now consider the second positive half cycle during its maximum value. This terminal will be positive and this terminal will be negative. During this entire positive half cycle, the capacitor C2 will find out a way to discharge its stored voltage 2Vm across it. Therefore, I can consider the Vm and 2Vm as two independent voltage source. Now consider the diode D1. You see that the positive terminal of this input voltage will be connected at the P side of the diode D1 and the negative terminal will be connected at the N side of the diode D1. The positive terminal of this 2Vm is connected with the inside of the diode and the negative terminal of this 2Vm is connected with the P side of the diode. That means this 2Vm can easily override the effect of the input voltage in case of the diode D1. Therefore our diode D1 will be in reverse bias. So when a diode is in reverse bias, I can replace that diode with an open circuit. Now consider the diode D2. As this is our diode D2, you will see that the positive terminal of the input voltage will be connected at the N side of the diode D2 and the negative terminal will be connected at the P side of the diode D2. Vm. The positive terminal of the 2Vm is connected with the N side and the negative terminal is connected with the P side. Therefore, both of the capacitor voltage and the input voltage are driving the diode D2 in reverse bias. So the diode D2 will be replaced by open circuit 2. That means I can remove the branch from this point to this point or the branch from this point to this point. Ultimately, I can remove this portion, the circuit that containing the branches that are containing the diode D1, D2 and the capacitor C1 in the voltage tripler circuit. Now consider the case of diode D3. You will see that the positive terminal of the capacitor voltage will be connected with the P side of the diode D3 and the negative terminal will be connected with the N side of the diode D3. 2Vm. The positive terminal of the input voltage is connected with the P side of the diode D3 and the negative terminal is connected with the N side of the diode D3. That means both the input voltage Vi and the capacitor voltage are trying to drive the diode D3 in forward bias. So diode D3 will be replaced by a short circuit. So during this positive half cycle, the capacitor C2 will discharge its voltage through the capacitor C3. Therefore, I will get charging current flowing in this direction indicated by these green arrows. Okay. Therefore, this terminal of the capacitor will be positive and this terminal of the capacitor will be negative as the charging current is entering at this terminal of the capacitor C3 and leaving the capacitor in this direction. So this terminal will be positive and this terminal will be negative, and you will see that the voltage across the capacitor will be applied across our load resistor RL. So I can calculate our output voltage by applying Kirchhoff's voltage law. See, if I apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in clockwise direction, KVL, okay, apply KVL to calculate output voltage. Output voltage VO will be equal to our VC3. So you will see that at first I will encounter the input voltage and its negative terminal, so its voltage will be positive plus Vm. After that I will encounter this capacitor and also its negative terminal, so plus 2 Vm. After that I will encounter this Vo, our output voltage, or this capacitor voltage V3 and its positive terminal. Therefore our voltage will be negative, so from which I can calculate our output voltage will be 3 Vm. Therefore our output voltage is 3 times the maximum value of our input voltage. This is why we call this circuit as voltage tripler circuit. Okay, that's it. Thank you.